Show. Got your boy Judy here. All right. I'm warning you, I'm stuck on stupid today. I got 2 hours of sleep. What do you do when you get 2 hours of sleep? You just sit there and be like, I wonder when I'm gonna get some more sleep. It was kind of nice. I ate a whole bunch of like sleeping pills to go to bed, and I just didn't. And I just was just kind of laid there like faded. But then you don't know how faded you are until you like stand up and then try to move, and you're like, whoa. And you're like, wow. I'm really on one. When you're laying down, you're just sitting there like, kind of, you know. It's like the field sobriety test. You don't know how drunk you are until you start trying to touch your nose and shit like that. Same deal. I had to shuffle shit around. I'm supposed to hang out with the lady today.
Oh, it's that bad.
I'm fucking useless. I'm fucking useless, dude. I just pushed it. And I had some other shit that I gotta handle too, but like, yeah, that was I probably could have juggled some shit. I was just like, let's rain check.
How'd she take that?
She was cool. She was cool about it. I gave her a heads up. And the other shit I had to handle was about some business. So like, I think when you're dealing with grown-ups, like a business comes up when you're casually dating somebody, I think both sides understand. And if they don't, then like, if I got some shit with some chick and she's like, hey, work called me to do some shit, and I throw a temper tantrum, that's a red flag that I'm not the guy for you, career woman. Like, if someone trips on you because you gotta make fucking money, you know what I mean? Like, yo, I gotta fucking handle some shit. What? You said we're gonna do this, and that. Like, what? You're not my girlfriend, bro. You better chill the fuck out. But she ain't. She was cool. So, yeah, she handled it. She handled it right. And she's done me like that before, too. Like, had to have, like, war, you know. They got the Zoom meetings and shit. I'm gonna show up this time because they popped a Zoom meeting on me. I'm like, cool. It's just the way it goes nowadays. I wonder how that is. Like, now that people are working from home and they got the Zoom meetings, like, do jobs give like less of a fuck about your time? Like, hey, we're gonna have a Zoom meet, like just springing Zoom meetings on you because they know you can't go anywhere and shit.
I've noticed that.
Do they?
Sure.
Yeah. That.
But I've actually taken a few on the bike. I just put it on the phone, put a little stand, pedaling around town. Oh, look, there's John zipping around.
Fucking your background is continuously moving. They're like, what the fuck?
Sometimes I'll turn it off just because it annoys them, I think, but
it's dedication. I swear to God, before, like, I've said this time and time again, before I got the job, I never worked in any like corporate setting, and I really wanted to be like in meetings and like participate, you know, like, and like help the company move forward with good ideas. That is not what meetings are. It's just a bunch of fucking assholes getting free bagels and listening to themselves talk.
There's plenty of talking, and you can figure out the repeat offenders pretty quickly.
Oh, yeah. Like, yeah.
If you stop talking, we can all leave.
Yeah. It's, with Sirius, it's gotten to the point where I just go in there and get a bagel and leave.
I can't do that.
I'm like, what's up, y'all? Get my little bagel, leave. Get the fuck out.
But I love them all. Good people.
Yeah, look, man, that's the problem, man. Like, everyone's nice individually, and then you get them in a group, and then people fucking get all weird. I think there's, like, science for that, you know what I mean?
I remember I pissed a lot of people off once when they said, "Are you coming to the meeting?" I said, "No, I have work to do." And that was not a cool thing to say. I had to apologize for that.
They're like, "This is work. Us complaining about shit that we've been complaining about since forever, and me talking about my own personal things." Yeah. So all y'all, thank your lucky stars that you don't have to go to fucking meetings that don't do anything. It'd be cool to be in a company where, like, they have a meeting that actually does some shit. You know what I mean?
I've heard those, too. People are screaming at each other behind closed doors. Those sound pretty productive.
Yeah.
Something's going on.
Yo, there used to be... There was some lady that doesn't work here anymore, man. I loved her, man. She would just fucking... She would just fucking... It was like the 60s. She'd go in on motherfucking cats.
I think I know who you're talking about.
She ain't with us no more, but
right.
For that brief time, I was like, yeah, get him. Sound like fucking like Vince Lombardi or some shit like that. Pat Riley. Fucking just going in on them cats. I was like, yeah, get them motherfuckers. I honestly don't mind getting yelled at if I'm wrong. Like, all right, dude, I'm wrong, you know. As long as you don't, like, fucking point your finger or it's all up in my face or anything like that, but whatever. I've been wrong before, you know. We all have. You just gotta take that shit on the chin, keep it pushing. Gotta take that shit on the chin, keep it pushing. Speaking of wrong, we're lining you up to get some shit wrong.
Wonderful.
We haven't done it in a minute. We're doing Bars vs. John. Strictly because I'm too fucking dumb to do anything today. I'm down about 12 IQ points.
So I'm going to leap on the grenade.
Yeah, you're going to hop on this hand grenade.
Thanks.
We're going to shit on you because I'm fucking... isn't that awful? We're going to shit on you because I'm too fucking dumb to run a goddamn show right now because I didn't sleep. And I promise y'all, I didn't drink no coffee or nothing. It was no, like, I didn't do any fucking... I drank GHB at, like, fucking, I think, 7 or 8, you know? It wasn't, like... It shouldn't have went down that way, you know what I mean? I don't know. Maybe I had some other shit on my mind. Who the fuck knows?
Oh, by the way.
Yeah.
I think it was last week at some point. This guy, Omar, out of Arizona, he called in and you gave him advice about eating ass.
Oh, yeah. Is he here?
And he is now checking in to provide an update on this.
Oh, yeah. Because Omar. Omar, what's up?
Hey, what's up, dude?
How you doing, man? You, your girlfriend ate your butt.
Yeah, bro. So I tuned things up. I shaved my asshole for her, and I did the Superman one, man. But I also did the doggy style one, and she was milking me like a cow and eating my ass out at the same time. And bro, I nutted so hard it was. I had the fucking cerebral palsy feet going. Oh, bro, it was the best thing ever. The Superman one was okay, but she couldn't get up all in there.
Yeah, I did. So, yeah, you sacrifice. So yeah, I had to go. You sacrifice sensation for being able to feel like a man. But so the doggy style with her milking you like a cow was that was the winning. That's the winner out of all three that you've tried.
Yeah, that was the winner, man. I'm telling you. Yeah. It was the best thing.
Were you talking shit to her? Were you talking shit while it happened? Were you like, yeah, eat that asshole? Or were you just
Oh, yeah. I mean, I had to get down and dirty, you know?
What was you saying?
Yo, you still there, dude?
Yeah, what were you saying to her?
Oh, man, I was just like, yeah, spit my ass and fucking stick your tongue in there. Was fucking jerking my shit. And she was like blowing bubbles on it. Like I don't know how to explain it, but it was fucking soaking wet, bro.
Word. Oh, my God, dog. Yeah, there you go.
It was the hottest shit. If I farted, I would have blew a bubble.
Yes, yeah, so there you go. Salad tossing there.
I'll definitely be trying some more, maybe some different positions. I don't know what else to try. But,
man, I don't know how many more.
It's good orgasm.
Yeah. I mean, it's even the Ghetto Boys talk about it and Gangster Love.
The ass is where it's at, brother. I hate to say it.
Yeah, there's a bunch of rappers that kind of talk about that shit. So, congratulations. We wanted the update and we got it. He tried all the different positions and all fours was the one for Omar. Congratulations. You figured it out and your girlfriend's a trooper. Did she appreciate?
Yeah, she wanted to try toys, but I said let's not go there yet.
Yeah, I feel like she's grooming you for us. Watch out, man. She might be grooming you for some pegging, bro.
Yeah, I'm thinking like a butt plug or something first. She's going to start small and then fucking probably work her way up, yeah, into some pegging shit.
That's what she's working on. Yeah, she's maybe stepping her way.
I can't let that happen.
Yeah, know your boundaries. Just let her think that she's doing it and then just be like, nah.
Right? Hey, Jude.
Yeah.
John yells at me ever again, bro. I'm going to go down there to Los Angeles, walk in fucking SiriusXM and knock him right in the fucking chin.
All right, come on, Omar. That's right.
He'll toss your salad.
He was lenient today. He was lenient today, but the other day he yelled at me. He got a little aggressive.
Well, I'm sure you... I see. It's done out of love. I'm sure you're on a speakerphone. I'm sure you had the radio blaring or something.
Oh, yeah. Fuck, John. Here we go.
Yeah. Right. Look, John's a mixture of fucking, like, he's on the spectrum, man. You just got to give him a break. I've heard him prep callers before, and I can't believe the way he speaks to some of these people.
What are you talking about?
I've heard you prep callers before. Like, you're, you be just saying the worst shit ever. You know what I mean?
I'm precise, trying to get it done fast.
Bang, you're like, nobody wants to hear that. Just do this and that. I'm like, that is not the nicest way to say that shit.
I've caught myself a couple times and I had to dial it back. But it seems.
Or even with old boy yesterday, you, like, we're trying to have like an uplifting fucking interview, and you just start talking about the hurricane with him when you're show prepping. I'm like,
I asked him about the weather. I asked him about the weather,
dude.
I forgot there was a. I mean, I asked him about the weather.
For fuck's sakes, bro! I was just like, really, man? Like, I'm trying. This is supposed to be an uplifting interview, and it's not that we can't talk about that, but like, I'm trying to. We got this doctor. It was a great interview, by the way. It was a fucking awesome interview. You can listen to it on demand. And John's prepping him and just starts talking about like the worst shit ever. I'm like, they're supposed to be in a good mood when they get on here with me. You fucking downer. You fucking downer. All right. So we're gonna do John versus BARZ versus John, E40 edition.
Oh boy.
He's a tricky one. He's a tricky one. Dusted and disgusted. It's a quick verse. Don't go anywhere. After that, it's the news, and then after that, it is the pill mix.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shay 45. We about to play a game. Yes, indeed. It's not a game. It's more a beating. Actually, it's called BARZ versus John. You've been doing pretty good so far.
As long as I can hear the words. I get screwed up on the slang, obviously, but when I can't even understand what they're saying, then I'm on my own.
Yeah.
It's a mess.
Which makes it good. Mm. Today we're this one's, I don't think it's that hard, but it's E40. This is like an easier E40. really could have fucked you up on some E40 shit, but maybe down the road. So we're gonna do Dusted and Disgusted, and we're gonna do a quick verse from Dusted and Disgusted. It's off his In a Major Way album, Posse Cut, and it's his, I believe it's his second verse off of Dusted and Disgusted. And we're gonna see how you do. Are you ready?
As I'll ever be.
I guess what we can do is we'll play the whole verse right now, and then we'll go back, and then we'll break it down line for line so people can hear it.
That helps me.
All right, there
so
you go.
So let me know when, I mean, I'll figure it out, but just say, hey, stop, when the verse
ends
is done.
It ends with Pac.
Okay.
All right. Here you go.
Here we go.
And disgusted. Let's let off some 203s on the other side of town. Draw the attention on the other side of town. And wait for the popo shift to change. Ghetto shooting range, revenge on a rebound. War games, droughts, ouch, lost clientele. But I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine. Pop sick for sale narcotics. When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about to chop. When my nigga plot.
God, can you forgive me?
Oh, man. I mean,
that's an easy one too. Let's go line for line.
We've had worse.
All right, here it is. Let's start from the top.
Then disgusted. Let's let off some 203s on the other side of town. Draw the attention on the other side of town.
All right. Okay. So I'm a drug dealer. All right. So and we've got to figure some shit out. Some stuff's going south on the streets, and we're gonna let off some 203s, which that's got to be a caliber, right? That's got to be a gun. I mean, I've never heard of it, but it's got to be a gun. All right, so hey, Billy, take the 203 on the other side of town, and then fire that shit off, and you're gonna draw the popos over there, the police, right? Isn't that what they said? Something like that, or
the popo shift to change, ghetto shooting range, revenge on a rebound. Town, draw the attention on the other side of town, and wait for the popo shift to change, ghetto shooting range, revenge on a rebound.
All right, so then, okay, but no, the police, they're going to do a shift change, so they're going to be distracted doing their thing, and we're going to draw some gang members over to the other side of town so we can do something else on this side of town.
Okay, all right.
War games, droughts, ouch, lost clientele, but I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crackle.
What? What?
A rebound. War games, droughts, ouch, lost clientele, but I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine. Drops, but still narcotic.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay. So there's a drought, and since I'm a drug dealer, there's a drought. So is there a drought to me? Okay. So yes, I'm the drug dealer, and then therefore what's happening is there's not enough product on the street, and I heard him say something about pot. I know he was referring to pot rather than the crack. So I'm gonna shift things up, start selling this good marijuana.
Thanks. When it's talking season.
Right. Close.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ouch, lost clientele, but I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine. Drops for sale narcotics. When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about.
Which
the
one?
What?
Which one? Which is which? Like, what? Which is
Well, again, remember, I lived up in Humboldt, so he must be talking about pot, broccoli.
All right, there you go. All right. Well, yeah, be specific, because I don't know what the fuck you're saying, you know? 8-8-7-4-2-3-3-4-5.
All right, but okay,
from
I'll
the
go.
Bay, you can call up and grade them.
Droughts, ouch, lost clientele, but I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine. Drops for sale narcotics. When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about the chow. When my nigga pop.
What? All right, yeah, I'm really confused suddenly. Hang on a second. I mean, I know there's some sort of street war going on in the drug market.
But I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine. Drops off the sale narcotics. When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about to chow. When my...
I don't know. I mean, I can't even understand what he's fucking saying. Hang on. Broccoli dank. I mean, that's where we were. Okay. So he's going to move to that. And... the cocaine, oh man! That was one more time, and then I'll just lay it down because I'm at a loss here.
All right.
When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about the chow. When my nigga pop.
God, can you forgive?
All right, okay. So there are people out there trying to steal my drugs, and let's see. There's something about bitches in there. So the hookers are doing something, and they're fucking up the market. And then Oh shit, man. I mean, so are the hookers like, okay, no, okay. All right, okay. So the hookers, everyone's investing in hookers. And then so I think that I'm going to still prevail because I'm going to sell my fucking great weed I got from Humboldt. That's the best I got, man. I don't know. I don't know what the hell is going on there. I don't know.
Yeah. The song's about getting back at somebody.
Huh?
The song is like about revenge on somebody. Like the drought is because they're going to war with these cats.
Okay. Okay. But I mean, is it over?
So he lost clientele, but he will prevail by selling broccoli. So you were like right like that. You were close. And but 203s aren't guns.
What are they?
It's a police code for like mayhem or like some shit's going crazy. So they make some shit go crazy over on the other side of town to send the cops over there.
Oh,
so that okay. They can go attack their enemy.
Got it. Okay.
And he's saying bitches be the reasons why smoke comes out the chop. Do you know what the chop is?
The chop. That would be my neighborhood. I'm over in the chop. This is where Matthews hangs out. Right?
Man, it's smoke comes out.
A chop. That's a gun. That's a gun.
The chopper. Yeah, smoke comes out the chopper. Yeah.
Okay, got it. Okay, the chop is good. Got it. All right. Hey?
Not bad, John.
Got really dicey towards the end.
I mean, you were like, the shit you were fucking far off on, you were way off on, but you did better than I thought.
Well,
congratulations.
Thank you.
You got anybody that want to grade you?
Not that I can see. There are a couple out there, but Kane's working on them. It looks like a long journey.
Wasn't your best performance. Wasn't your worst. It wasn't your worst. So you tackled E-40. Maybe down the road we'll give you some more complicated E-40 shit.
Right. I mean, again, at least I knew I was in the neighborhood, but by the end, I was really leaving the rails.
Yeah. Chop's your neighborhood, bro. Yep. Man, John's in the chop. Fucking John's in the chop, son. Doing that shit. All right, that was BARZ versus John. Coming up next, who knows? Stick around. All right. It's All Out Show, y'all. Let's get it.
I'm really not all that sure about when things is finna mature, so let me find me a nigga with a grip and hit his ass quick with one of them licks.
What's the definition of a lick?
Taking a nigga shit.
Hey, put that on something.
I'll put that on the click. Back to fucking work. One of the homies just got dusted. Time to do some dirt. I never trusted them busters. Shot him in the shirt. Dead on arrival. Now the town is funky. It's called survival. What y'all wanna do? They got us stumped.
We can just
die. If it was a fifth, well, I'll be drunk. I'm heated. Them niggas cheated. Played me false. We had a meeting. Shit, post a bean squash. I noticed one kid with a double dribble and set him up, y'all. She likes the money in the middle. Play the ball, thick ass bitch, high yellow city slicker, scarecrow grabbing something bitches, AKA potency pussy fixation. She gonna hold them gas, but shit on his stuff, and the phone get real, pulling out bills, front number trio shit. That's when I get the killing shit,
killing
setting them up and having them catching a couple of slugs, slugs, trying to fuck with this savage drug, pistol popping their ass. See niggas be getting it twisted, it's that bitch that killed you, took all your money, pilch you. Seven niggas busting the room with a case while they're playing on this jammy. All of a sudden, they shoot up your head tap before you can hit the broccoli. See money and make that nigga that make that money, let them niggas jack up. And that bitch, he mackin', he's a buster, punk ass nigga. Don't know the streets, that's why that nigga naked, laying dead in between some bloody sheets. It's just a part of the game he didn't feel. Bitches will kill, fuck a nigga, I just slashed a dollar bill. You don't know that hoe, man, that bitch can't be trusted. Dusted and the motherfucking disgusted. Back to fucking work, one of the homies just got dusted. What y'all wanna do? What y'all wanna do? Back to fucking work, one of the homies just got dusted. What y'all wanna do? I never trusted them busters. Busted and disgusted.
Let's let off some 203s on the other side of town. Draw the attention on the other side of town. And wait for the popo shift to change. Ghetto shooting range, revenge on the rebound. War games, droughts, ouch, lost clientele, but I won't prevail by selling a broccoli dick instead of the crack cocaine drops for sale narcotics. When it's talking season, bitches be the reason why the smoke be coming about to chow. Will my nigga pop?
Dear God, can you forgive me? My future's looking sick, I'm in my bag. Getting stitches, I'm suspicious of these. I keep on calling, but ain't nobody picking up. I think she's stalling. It's evil bitches trying to set me up. Came all alone, if it's on, then it's on. What's my motherfucking clone? Only jealous niggas don't, it's a war zone. But I'm a man, so a gun in hand. I'm on my way to see this hoe, you know the fucking plan. Can't understand, but the things ain't the same. You can die over these bitches if you're slipping in the gang. Niggas gang bang, but bitches gang bang. You give up that good thing. Put that pistol to your brain and you a smart figure. Don't have no love in your heart, nigga. Any complications, pull a trigger. Busted and disgusted, bitches can't be trusted. You know the rules, they underhanded. She planned it, you fucking fool.
These hoes out here trying to hold niggas high, so a nigga get his motherfucking balls to the wall.
Hey, you can drive it when you turn these bitches upside down. What's gonna happen?
$3.5 will probably fall out of this pocket.
Yeah,
right,
man.
I'm
fuck
the California lifestyle that I live, where the bitches is crooked and niggas just don't give. But flying fuck, so I stay stuck, smoking on the Taylor. Red area player, trying to have shit major. And a bitch won't save ya, so I ain't playing Captain Save a hoe. I'm out with you like a Roman, then I'm gone. I'm like Sylvester Stallone. Every day is like a cliffhanger, action packed. I let the men and Max play.
Jack that ass, nigga would've got smoking on that hash. Can't have my cash, better go and take your nigga stash. Cause he's a buster, fingers with clusters, slipping and shit. Yeah. Better jack that nigga for I jack his ass, bitch. Never was no love for the market ass, the low pack.
The low pack.
He left them boozy bitches.
Can't let them boozy bitches gank dead ass. Better hide your cash and check her fast. Pump your brakes, nigga, slow your road, don't go too fast. Cause bulletproof say you ain't no good no more, no more, no more, no more, man. Niggas coming up dead with they break. Flew out on the fucking floor, damn. Holla push to the first time, fly through the best desk. Now we're arrest. Pull a plug on the flatline, no paroles. One nigga less, one nigga less. From coast to coast to the east to the west. Fresh in the flesh. Them bitches play the game of death. Look over your shoulder, watch your back. Don't even trust it. I'm trying to tell you, end up dusted.
Black the fucking blood.
One of the homies just got dusted. What y'all wanna do? What y'all wanna do?
Black
the fucking blood. One of the homies just got dusted. What y'all wanna do? I never trusted them.
Black
the fucking blood. One of the homies just got dusted. I never trusted them. Black the fucking blood. One of the homies just got dusted. Dusted and disgusted.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
You're tuned in to the All Out Show. Just your little fucking, sigh and exhale on your way home from work, or if you're working from the house, or you just need to decompress. Here we are for you. You can follow All Out Show at All Out Show on everything. We also release pill mixes. You can go text 213-205-3747, type in pill mix, and or if you want merch, you can type in merch. And sometimes I send group text to everybody, but it's like once a month type shit, and whatever mixes I make at the house. So there's like non-rap mixes too, in case you want to mix it up. I'm not guaranteeing that you're gonna like them. I'm just playing shit I like, though. Really sold you on that, didn't I? One More Jude is my Instagram, and onemorejude.com is my website where you can get gear for the All Out Show. It's just your little way of fucking letting cats know that you're not on that bullshit. That you're on that real shit. So, and proceeds go to fucking John and Keenan. Bam.
We could use it.
Just a t-shirt a day can help John buy some bottom shelf gin to get fucked up off of.
Every little bit helps.
We're really pulling for it. There it is. So, yeah. Not only are you repping the show, you're helping John fund his alcoholism. I don't know what Keenan does with the money. He's not like a fucking, he's not an addict.
It's not what I heard. No, he's not. No, he's not.
No, whatever. All right. Coming up next, it's the news. Don't go anywhere. All Out Show, y'all.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I have here a list of sex health facts and quirks that all guys should think about when it comes to performance.
All right. That's how people fuck.
So men last on average about 5 minutes during sex, while women last about 18 minutes.
So you got to do the foreplay.
That is key to the game.
Got to hit them with the foreplay.
And then also, the most sensitive part of the penis is the frenulum.
That's the underside.
Right near the head.
Yeah.
Didn't know it was called a frenulum. Thought that was in your mouth, but... If it's too sensitive...
It's in your mouth.
Hey, now. But if it's too sensitive, it leads to premature ejaculation. Is it really that sensitive? I don't know.
Man, the first rub and tug I ever got, I was in the Tenderloin. And I had this old Chinese wizard lady. She was like 60 or some shit. And she could tell I was a rookie. So she just like ran the price up on me, but my dick was already hard. So like I was just like, all right, fine. Like I think she got me for like $100. I usually like 50. And she did some move on me where she just hit the frenulum part mad fucking.
Wow.
Like just said, like hit her two fingers and just did it real soft, like up on it. That, and just punked a nut out of me. I was like, damn, dog. Like I couldn't even enjoy it. Blam. Just got me. Like, fuck. It's like, well played.
Didn't know that was the hot zone.
I didn't either. So she fucking put it on me like that. I was like, shit.
Of course, schmegma, it's a real thing. For those who don't know what it is, it's the foul-smelling cheese-like secretion that can form under male foreskin. So keep an eye on that.
Yeah. Keep it clean. Keep it clean, fellas. You uncut fellas.
Can you guess how fast the male ejaculate exits the penis?
The average?
Yeah.
Because mine just oozes out real sad. Like, it's like, wah, wah, wah.
Here it is.
Every time I nut, it should be a sad trombone. Wah, wah, wah. Let's see. It, 10 miles an hour.
You're almost there. 20 miles per hour, supposedly.
Damn, I was off. How far does it go, do they say?
Oh, I'd have to look in a different place for that. Mm-hmm. Depends on the person. With you, not too far, it seems like.
Nope. Nope.
See, but for me, if I masturbate too much, obviously that's when that happens. But if I let it go for a bit, bang. I mean, I can literally hit my chin.
Yeah, if you edge and shit, you can fucking bust crazy nuts. But usually I'm just trying to get that shit over with. It's just like a hurry up and like I'm not taking that much. I'm not spending a lot of time with myself. This is to just get it over with. Get it out of you.
With mood lighting and oils and music?
No. The internet porn has lost its luster. I remember when it first came out, it was like the illest shit ever. You're like, whoa, I can watch this and watch this. Your hand be cramped and shit. You look like cerebral palsy when you get done. But like, now it's just like, hurry up, get your nut, get on with your day.
Now, this one, you've always warned about this quickly, and I never really knew why, but you're saying what I'm doing with the dry masturbating, That's not a good thing, and it turns out it may not be a good thing.
Really?
Yeah, because I'm training myself to sort of, first of all, you know, nut quickly, but then also when I'm in a real vagina, then it's just a whole different scene, and then...
You're not even ready for it.
Exactly. Check that out.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Now that you say it like that, that totally makes sense.
All these years.
It's like train harder, you know what I mean? Like, you want to train harder than the game. So that when you get to the game, it's easy. You're making your penis weak.
I am that.
It touches some hot, warm shit. It's like, whoa, what the fuck is this? Hey, shit, goddamn.
This doesn't feel right.
It's fucking awesome. Dick don't know what to do, but nut. There you go. All right, look at that.
All right, so the NSA, they, of course, are spying on us all, have been for years. No big surprise there. But in a recent ruling, it looks like their controversial phone metadata program, a court is now saying that's illegal. Now, this is something that has been around for years, and it's been sort of crawling through the courts, but now they're saying they can't soak up everybody's data and then just look at it later and say, oh, well, that's what John did. They have to be more precise about it.
They're still gonna. You know,
that's,
right?
That's really the down. Like, well, okay, the judge said this, but...
Yeah, they're like, okay, judge. Sure, whatever you say, judge.
They're just gonna pat him on the head.
Yep, sure. Yeah, okay. Keep judging, judge. All right, thanks. Illegal? Got it. We won't do that anymore. Don't you worry about us. We got this covered. We're the fucking NSA. You can trust us. Yeah.
I don't know.
Just sit on your phone, dude. Just sit on that shit.
I guess if you have a case that's tied into this type of violation, talk to your lawyer. Perhaps they could try to get you out.
Yeah, but they'll just come up with some backdoor way to fucking get you. They'll use that information and just fucking get you another way.
One must try.
Yes. Yeah, try. Good luck. Good luck. I guess you can use burner phones and shit like that. And then the encrypted things, but I feel like those encrypted shits are ran by fucking the feds too.
Well, supposedly, the feds don't like those, and they're very public about that. So
yeah, that's what makes me think even more. Like, okay,
it's safe over here.
Like Wicker and Signal and shit like that. I wouldn't be surprised if the feds had their little fingers on that shit.
Well, the problem I found with Signal is that nobody wants to use it. So I'm pretty much the only person on Signal. So,
or I'll get a Signal, someone to hit me on that bitch. It'll be like 8 days later. I'll be like, oh, shit. Damn. All right. Fuck. Missed that move. There it is. What else?
All right. Now, also government related here. You've probably heard that the CDC talked about... some change in the way that they were looking at the deaths from COVID-19. And the idea is that, again, just be very slow on this. So the CDC supposedly recently updated their rules here, saying that only 6% of the nation's total reported COVID-19 deaths were actually from the virus. The remaining 94% died of other serious illnesses. Yeah, but slow down, man. Yeah, but this is being spun by some real political hacks.
I'm not saying anything.
All right.
You just look, the other shit was spun the other way. I'm just not saying anything. You guys think whatever the fuck you want. 6% of those deaths were actually really healthy people.
Okay, and but you know the remaining number of people, and this is a huge number. What's like 180,000 or something crazy like that. I mean, those people were obese; they had other heart conditions, yep. But they would have lived, man. They would have lived.
And how much longer?
I don't know. I have no idea.
That's sure. All right. Okay. I'm not saying nothing.
Okay.
You have to believe. Think whatever you want. Think whatever the fuck you want. So we shut that shit down for 6 months. 10,000 healthy people died. What else?
Fine.
I'm not saying nothing.
Dick.
I'm just sitting there smiling.
So, sleep scientists, they would like to cancel daylight savings time. Daylight saving time, I should say, sorry.
Thank you, bro. Please. It just fucking everybody, dude. I don't know anyone that is like, I don't know anyone that likes daylight savings time. Except for like that one guy who's like, yeah, get to fucking party 1 hour later at the bar. I'm like, I'd rather just be able to sleep.
I don't know. People always complain about it, and it does affect people in a profound way. I mean, does it take you out as well when suddenly?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm fucking off for like a week or two.
the science is telling us here that the twice a year transition not only is an inconvenience, but also increases the risk of various health problems and car accidents. So there's a spike each time this happens when people lose that hour. They're all screwed up.
I wonder how many people die of car accidents, how many healthy people die of car accidents. Maybe we should get rid of cars.
Hey. That's what Twitter's for.
It's for safety, right? Yeah. Don't you care about saving other people's lives? I don't want to kill anybody, do you?
Nope.
Why are you driving?
How was your sleep these days?
Oh, I slept 2 hours last night.
Not good.
Oh, I'm fucked. I'm absolutely fucked. But we're going to get through it today.
Yeah.
We're getting through it. I don't even know what the problem was either. I didn't drink caffeine or anything. I just fucking just up. Fucking sweet.
Okay, so there is a lady over in Thailand who is, I'm going to text you the image here that is upsetting to some, but she was allowed to get into a tiger cage for reasons that are very confusing to me. And then she decided to grab the tiger's testicles and then take a photo of this. And what did she write? Pray in your heart and squeeze hard, then you'll be free from suffering.
There you go. I don't know what the fuck that... That must be some old fucking Thai fucking haiku or some shit like that. I don't know. So...
Boy, those are the big testicles.
Are there more tigers in captivity than, like, free? Is that what that shit is? Is that one of the deals? It's something like that.
Yeah. It's not good. And, of course, they're pointing out the tiger was most likely drugged during this experience.
Yeah, I'm sure he was fucking sedated. Like, tigers usually aren't into people just running up and grabbing their nuts.
That's insane.
I find zoos to be kind of weird anyway, you know? It's like fucking little animal prisons.
Yeah, I know. They're kind of grim.
Yeah, man. You'll see the dumb animals all like happy and shit. Then you'll see the smart animal in the corner like, bro, I'm in animal prison. You know what I mean? Like, fuck me. This ain't life. So, I mean, I get the backlash, but then at the same time, it's like, yo, you already got him in animal prison. You know? Like,
well, even going as far as saying this is animal abuse.
How's the animal, like, if I'm sure they had to knock the tiger out for some shit. What did it rob the tiger of its dignity?
Those are some of the comments, of course.
It's in fucking animal prison, dog.
Boy, she's wild, though. Just running up and grabbing a tiger's nuts.
Yo, grabbing a nut and writing a poem and shit. Okay. Like, whatever, dog. Like, would I do it? No. But, like... Find something else to get mad about. Hey, there's slavery going on in like fucking Africa right now. Maybe you can get mad about that instead of some lady grabbing a fucking tiger's nuts.
When was the last time you ever went to a zoo?
Man, I ain't been to a zoo in for fucking ever. Man, this shit was depressing as hell, man. I just walked around and it was just like, man, this shit is sad as hell. I went to LA has a zoo in like Griffith Park, and it was like the most pathetic, sad zoo. All the animals look like they're on suicide watch and shit. Raggedy ass little pens. You're like, oh man.
Yeah, it's not a happy place.
Nah. No. And like, look, I'm sure that there's some zoos that do it as good as one could do a zoo. But at the end of the day, they're not in their natural habitat. And I understand the argument that, like, yo, you might be able to keep a fucking animal around longer. But if it doesn't get to be, if it doesn't really get to be itself, then what's the fucking point? Part of being a tiger is like prowling through the fucking forest and being a fucking tiger, not being locked in some fucking 100-foot by 100-foot thing. You're taking away the whole essence of the tiger. to maintain the tiger.
And if you do go to the zoo, don't grab its balls. This lady's very lucky. And I could have been a little intense for her.
I think the upside is she's like in Thailand and they're like more chill about that type of shit, I'm guessing. She's probably getting like slack from around the world. But, you know, they're a little more chill over there in Asia about their mistreatment of animals. And I'm putting that in quotes.
Does seem like it's a little more lax over there.
Oh yeah, man! You go to some of them spots. Though. I forgot what country, and I don't. I'm not trying to conflate all Asian countries because each country has their own like their own customs and shit. But like, they went to some My man went to some fancy restaurant, and they just brought like one of them like paint buckets. And it just had an eel in that bitch like, to dinner. Like, here, this is what you're gonna be eating: a fucking eel in a in some water with a paint bucket. And you know, the American guys has to look down. Oh, it's a beautiful eel. Thank you very much. And then they went and you go fucking murk that shit and bring it out to you. So they just got a different way of looking at things. I think it's a healthier way to looking at shit. To be real with you. Mm-hmm. They're okay with being top of the food chain.
All right, so in the future, some scientists are looking at worms as a good thing to eat. The yellow mealworm.
Ugh,
I know. But of course, with you know the growing population and some shortages that will undoubtedly happen, you'd have a good protein source here. And you'd eat your mealworm meal, and it can serve as an alternative food source for many animals, such as fish. Their waste can be used as an organic fertilizer.
Hey.
They don't look very appetizing.
What do they say? Excuse me. Do they say what they taste like?
They do not say chicken, but it's always chicken.
Man, honestly, you deep fry anything, that shit's edible. Just throw some batter on that shit and deep fry it. You can eat it. Throw some hot sauce on it. But, nah. That's gonna be a fucking... I've tried that shit. I tried the fucking, like, cricket shit just to try it, you know? Like, fuck it, I'll eat a fucking bug, whatever. But I'm not gonna be seeking out bugs anytime soon.
That looks like they have a super mild flavor. They don't really taste like much. Mealworms. I mean, you're the guy who recently ate what was it, like a nose of a pig or something, or an eyeball,
yeah.
Or
yeah, just ate that shit.
Ugh.
Well, it's dead already, so I figured you eat the whole fucking thing. You know what I mean?
Would you have done that at home if you'd not been at a party? Would you take the eyeball out of the fridge and just hey, let me eat this eyeball?
Well, I wouldn't have had a pig's face at my house, John. Oh.
Ugh.
I just get cold cuts.
Well,
so the answer would be no. No, I would not, because that wouldn't even... In my 42 years, I've never had a pig face in my fucking crib.
That would make sense.
Yeah. And it wasn't nothing. It was like eating a BB or some shit like that.
Mm.
A little chewable BB, crunchy, chewy. Man, yeah, maybe we can tackle that mealworm one like 50 years down the line. We got that. We can put that in our back pocket on some just in case shit. But like, nah,
I don't think we need to fast track that either.
No, we don't. And especially us, like we're America.
Ah. There must be somebody out there listening who eats mealworms.
Whatever floats your boat. I'm not gonna stop you from eating fucking mealworms. I'm not lining up to do that shit. You know, fuck that. Unless, like, how much protein is in the mealworm? Are they a superfood? You know what I mean? Like, is mealworms a superfood? Is there an upside, or is it just like
Well, again, they're just saying this is a good substitute for these other animals, so it must provide something comparable to what you're getting from, let's say, your salmon or something like that.
Yeah, and like, and here's the thing: different cultures eat different shit. You know, some cultures eat field rat, other cultures eat fucking dogs, other cultures don't. Just other cultures eat bugs. Just that's just not part of our culture, so it'd be something you'd have to really slowly fucking work in.
Yeah, I think I'd go vegan before I started chowing down on mealworms on a regular basis.
straight up, yeah. I'd be like, y'all got some of them beans?
No, thank you.
Straight up pintos? Let me get some pinto beans. I'm good on the mealworms. Give me some good news.
And now, time for good news.
There is a new documentary out that is looking at the Paralympics, and it just came out on Netflix, and it reminded me of this guy who is a world-class archer, and he has no arms. He was born without arms.
So he does it like with he holds with his foot and pulls with his teeth. Is that it?
He has some sort of strap around his torso here, and then it looks like, of course, he's got his feet controlling the bow, and then the arrow it is in his chin. So then he lines it up, and then boink, well, what's
that's
it?
Fucking dope.
That's a rip. And he was born without arms, and he was even adopted at some point. So he's got quite a tail behind him, but he's also quite a driver. It's incredible to see him do these things. I got him here talking about some of his struggles for a second, if you want.
All right, let's hear it.
People are always going to stare. People still stare to this day, you know. So at a young, like around 8, I guess, 7 or 8 is when I really was like, I don't care what people think of me anymore. I don't care that I'm funny looking or different. I don't care that they're staring. And I really took that mindset into pretty much everything else in my life, which led me today to here I am. And that was because my parents instilled that in me when I was little.
All right.
Bam.
So at the Paralympics back in 2012, he won a silver. And really, I mean, he's really a serious archer. He did not let that stop him.
That's a bad motherfucker right there. Good shit.
Matt Stutzman out of Iowa.
You can do anything you put your mind to it. Will, hard work, dedication. You can go get it. Nothing can stop you. And that's the news.
And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John C. Matthews.